put in another month in on it, but yeah. We're gonna run hard. I'll probably stay out of some water holes, but
yeah,
we found some deep stuff over there in the Mountain Man course last night.
Really?
I mean, gnarly. Just.
So what is your goal for this weekend? Just to kind of.
This weekend is test and tune. We're gonna run it hard. I just probably stay out of some of the bigger holes. And one thing about them tires, they definitely throw stuff. You better be wearing goggles.
So no king of the pit.
No, not for this guy. No, I don't like water. Water's not my friend.
I don't blame you at all.
You throw me in anybody else's rig, I'll do it.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Justin will let me run X-rated. I'll run that pit all night long. Last year, all this was pretty new. We took a lot of time off of wheeling in general. And then, actually last year, this qualifier, the LCQ, was when I brought the diesel buggy. And
we
pretty much sucked at life with that thing. So, realized that it can't be a competitive rig, but it will never be a top five rig. It's just not when you're running against guys like Justin and Leroy and Matt Christian. I mean, Matt had 10 minutes of seat time on his Colorado when he got here last year for Havoc. And that 10 minutes was backing it out of the shop, driving it up to his tractor, checking the articulation out, backing it back up and loading it on a trailer. He never wheeled that truck. And he showed up and he took third place.
Wow.
And Havoc could have won a lot of different ways last year. I mean, Porkchop and the Mountain Man. What was he down? 3 or 4 minutes? Couldn't get his rig started. That would have secured him. If that motor wouldn't have shut down, he would have been done. Leroy, the rock pile over there at the tree. If he wouldn't have got hung up, you know, there would have been no questions. There would have never been a tie. Matt Christian, if he wouldn't have lost his belt on the hip ceiling hole, he would have secured it. I mean, Justin, he lost his rear steer. He ran Mountain Man with no rear steer. He lost his tire in the rock garden, in the obstacle course, and he ran half of that course on 3 tires. So there's some badasses here, and everybody's going to run hard. So Cheston. What was he on fire 3 times on the tire drag? So, I mean, there was a lot of bad luck involved, and luck's got a lot to do with this style of racing, because every driver is going to make a mistake somewhere, and you're never going to go to a race and not make a mistake. It's going to happen, but luck's got a lot involved. Picking your right line. You can know and look at your line that you want, and you can't see out of this thing at all. I mean, it's
not bad, yeah.
It's
especially
blind.
When your foot in the throttle, yeah.
You put your foot in that thing and you get sideways real quick,
yeah.
And it gets you there right now, and then you're backing up. So.
Man needs little to no introduction. This is part of Team Morgan. This is Brett Harrell, ladies and gentlemen. Team change order, part of Team Morgan. He's got Neil on the co-dog seat. He's got twin turbo nasty 5.3, some brand new cut ag tires. He's got some 2-inch open sims, some ORI shocks. He's running that Northwest Fab Titan box. Running that full hydro front and rear steering, 20-inch shocks, double feet locks. He's got those cut 54-inch ags. Brett's a huge part of this sport, whether you know it or not. Now you're going to know it. He helps out with us here at the ranch. He helped arrange a dozer for us to build this event. This event wouldn't be the same without Mr. Harrell and his family helping us out. So if you get a chance, shake his hand, tell him thank you, because he added to this weekend a lot. All right, Brad, you're good to go, man. Good luck.
Yeah.